first example there on your paper, we need to divide 8x to the fourth plus 12x cubed plus 4x squared, and we need to divide that by 4. So we need to divide each and every term by that monomial right there. If you want to write this, I think it's a good idea. You may not need to, but I think it's a good idea to get that visual of what I'm actually doing so that I don't miss anything when I'm trying to simplify. So 8 divided by 4 is 2. And we can't do anything with the x to the 4th. 12 divided by 4 is 3. We can't do anything with the x cubed. And 4 divided by 4 is 1. So then we just have plus x squared there on the end. Let's look at one that's got a variable with it. So we need to divide this expression by 9x squared, number 2 here. So 3 over 9, well, that's not a whole number. That's going to be a fraction. 3 over 9 reduces to 1/3. X to the 4th over x squared, when you're dividing, you subtract exponents. So 4 minus 2 is 2, so that simplifies to 1/3 x squared. 45 over 9, 45 divided by 9 is 5. X cubed over x squared is x. We've got 45 divided by 9 again. But then x squared over x squared is 1, so that final term, doesn't have a variable. Okay. Now, one note, you may see this, the answer key may show it as instead of 1/3 x squared, that can also be written as x squared over 3. Okay, those are the exact same thing. Okay, so just keep that in the back of your mind. If you see that as an answer choice at some point in time or anything like that, they are the exact same expressions. Okay, let's look at number 3, dividing everything by 8b. So, coefficient-wise, b to the 4th, its coefficient is 1. We can't divide 1 by 8, so we just leave it written as 1 over 8. B to the 4th over b, well, b has an understood exponent of 1, so 4 minus 1 is 3, so we've got 1/8 b cubed. 40 divided by 8 is 5. B cubed over b is b squared. 40 divided by 8 is still 5, and b squared over b is b. Let's do one more because it introduces one more idea here to us. So let's divide all those terms by 10x cubed. 2 over 10 reduces to 1 over 5. X to the 4th over x cubed is x. 40 over 10 reduces to 4. X cubed over x cubed is 1. So that's just 4 by itself. 50 over 10 is 5. X squared over x cubed. The power is bigger on the bottom. So there are a couple of different ways of looking at this. That's one way to look at it. When you're dividing, you can always subtract the exponents and do the bigger number minus the smaller number. Minus 2, you put the result where the bigger exponent was. So 3 minus 2 is 1, we've got x to the first, but it was bigger in the denominator, so we're going to put that result in the denominator. So that reduces to 5 over x. Or you can look at it as 2 minus 3 is negative 1. You get rid of negative exponents by moving them between the denominator and the numerator. You'd end up with the same result there. Okay? Now, that's all the dividing that we're going to do with these. But let's go ahead and look at some of this factoring, okay? Because part of the purpose of doing the dividing is to help us with factoring. Because the first type that we're going to do is GCF factoring. Okay? So we're going to factor some quadratic expressions. Okay, the first few that we're going to look at, these are just binomials. Okay, these are just binomials. So we're not going to split it up into two sets of parentheses. Anytime you're factoring, you always want to look for a GCF first. That is always, always, always the first thing that you're going to do is to look for a GCF, because that can make your other factoring easier to do. Okay? So, if we look at example number 5, 8x squared plus 8x. You want to look at the coefficients first. 8 and 8, they both have 8. So that means 8 is our coefficient GCF. As far as their variables, we've got x squared and x, so you're going to go with the smaller of the two. They both have at least one x. One of them has two. Okay, so x is part of your GCF. So 8x is our GCF. We put that in front of our set of parentheses. Now, depending on how you feel about this, one easier way, I think, to look at GCF factoring is to look at it as when you take out a GCF, you're dividing by what your GCF is. So this can help you when you're trying to figure out what to put in your parentheses. So 8 divided by 8 is 1, x squared over x is x. And this is where most people will mess up. Okay, 8x over 8x, you might say that that cancels or whatever you may say, but you still have to put a 1 in its place. If you don't, you're going to lose a term of your expression. Okay, when things cancel, they equal 1. It's not that they equal 0 and disappear, they equal 1. So you got to make sure you get that 1 in its place, because anytime you factor, you can always check yourself by multiplying it back out. Distribute that 8x and you get 8x squared plus 8x. If you didn't have that plus 1 there, all you would get is 8x squared. And that was not your original expression. So keep that in the back of your mind. Anytime you can factor, you can always check it by multiplying it back out. All right? Let's look at number 6. 36 and 24. What is the largest number that will divide evenly into both 36 and 24? 12. Yes. I almost said 6, but 12 is bigger. You are correct. Okay, so 12 is part of our GCF. We've got m squared and m, just like the one that we just had. So m is the other part of our GCF. So when we simplify, or when we take out our GCF, we're left with 3m plus 2. All right, number 7, a little bit bigger numbers, right? I'm not quite so sure about 192, so whenever I'm trying to determine the GCF, I always start with that first coefficient. It would be great if 192 was evenly divisible by 24, and it is. So that was a not so difficult one. Okay, 24m is going to be our GCF here. And when we take out that GCF, we are left with m plus 8. 192 divided by 24 is 8. Okay. Number 8. One thing that we need to remember here is if there's a negative in front there, we need to take that out as a part of our GCF. So we need to go ahead and make our GCF negative. 54 is not evenly divisible by 12, so go to the next biggest factor of 12. That would be 6. 54 is divisible by 6. And we've got the same thing, k squared and k, so our variable part of our GCF is k. So when we take out a negative 6k, we are left with positive 2k, because negative 6 times positive 2 is negative 12. And we are left with minus 9. 54 divided by negative 6 is negative 9. All right. So let's take this idea of factoring out a GCF and extend it to factoring some trinomials. Okay. Now, whenever you see a trinomial, a quadratic trinomial like this, and you see a coefficient in front of your quadratic term, okay, the negative 4 in this case, you know that it's going to be a little bit more difficult factoring if you can't take out a GCF. So let's first of all check and see if it would be great if negative 4 were a GCF. Are all three of those terms divisible by negative 4? Yep, I know 4 and 44 are. 72 is as well. So we're going to take out a negative 4. When we take out the negative 4, we are left with m squared minus 11m plus, what is that, 13? Is it 13? 18? Thank you. Okay. M squared minus 11m plus 18. Now, we're not finished, okay? That expression right there will factor further. Hopefully you've been doing factoring like this for a while. the good thing is now our quadratic coefficient is 1. So that makes this a lot easier. We know that we've got m and m in the first place, in the first spots in each binomial. Now we just got to figure out what multiplies to give us 18 and adds to give us negative 11. Well, that would be 9 and 2. And it doesn't matter which order you put it in. Okay, the answer key has 2 and then 9. It really does not matter which order you put it in. The only time the order is going to matter is if those had opposite signs. you just have to make sure that the correct one had the correct sign. And then still, it's not really that the order matters. It's just you have to be careful with your signs. All right, number 10, GCF. We've got GCF of negative 5, so let's start by taking that out. When we take that out, we're left with a squared minus a minus, what, 5 goes into 28, 5 times 56. Okay, now this one's not quite as simple to factor because, excuse me, we still have a times a is the only thing that's going to give us a squared. But we've got to get negative 56, so we're going to have opposite signs. One's going to be positive, one's going to be negative. It's still not that bad, right? Because 8 times 7 gives us 56, and we need negative a, so that means that the 8 needs to be negative, and the 7 needs to be positive. Notice a common mistake is that when you're factoring out a GCF, some people will drop it. They won't bring it all the way down to the end. But you've got to keep that GCF throughout the whole problem or you've changed it. So make sure that that GCF stays in front of your factors. All right. Clue number 11. Well, so far that coefficient on our quadratic term has been the GCF. Is it the GCF this time? No, 57 isn't divisible by 9. 9 and 90 are, but 57's not. So we've got to go down a factor. 3 does work, though. Okay, 3 does work. So take out a 3 from every term. So we're left with 3x squared minus 19, thank you, 19x plus 30. Now, it's going to take a little bit more effort, but this is factorable as well, okay? Instead of it automatically being x times x, because x times x only gives us x squared, not 3x squared, we've got 3x times x. Okay, 3x times x is what's going to give us 3x squared. Now, we've got to work through our factors of 30. Now, them themselves are not going to... themselves are not going to add to us 19, okay? Because if you look at it, one of them, your outside number here, is going to multiply by 3. And that in conjunction with this term right here is going to be the 19. So, what are the first factors of 30 to pop into mind? What? 10 and 15 and 2? 10 and 3? I've heard both of them. So, how about we go with, I think of 10 and 3 are the first ones that pop in my mind. So, we've got to figure out which order to put it in, okay? Do we need to multiply the 10 by 3, or do we need to multiply 3 by 3 if we're trying to get to 19?
What would happen if we multiply 10 by 3? We get 30, right? Let's just do a little trial and error here. The outside gives us 30. The inside gives us 3. Is that going to, in any way, shape, or form, give us 19?
No.